Your Excellencies, the Reverend Fathers, the Religious Sisters, the Seminarians, Brothers and Sisters in Christ. There are three Jubilarians, Father Mario, Father Alvin, Father Allen. But there is only one Jubilee. There are three priests. There is only one vocation. Because our gathering this afternoon is not about the three Jubilarians. Our prayer this afternoon is about Him who makes possible all Jubilees. So there is only one Jubilee because there is only one Lord. There is only one vocation because there is only one voice. There is only one ministry because there is only one minister. And the meaning of all of these is Jesus Christ, the Good Shepherd. Father Mario, Father Allen, and Father Alvin carry different vocation stories. But their vocation stories have only one source, the vocation that came from the Lord. A vocation is a calling. A calling is a voice. It is a voice that has been heard. It is a different kind of voice because it is a voice that does not come from the throat. It is a different kind of voice because it is a voice that is not heard with the ears. It is a different kind of voice because it is the voice of a soul that only another soul can hear. It is the voice of a pure voice. It is the voice of a pure God, which only the pure of heart will be able to hear. That voice was heard in different families, in different stories, from different towns. And then they answered yes. That voice is quite mysterious, because if you're so sure that you heard with your ears that God is telling you, come be a priest, that is certainly one sure reason that you are not called to be a priest. Because the voice of God is not heard by human ears. The voice of God is heard by another organ of listening. And it is the soul, it is the heart, it is the mind, it is the spirit. So 25 years ago, their vocation story received a confirmation. The church called them by name. Mario, Alvin, Allen, and they all responded, Ad sum, I am here, I am present here, I come to do your will. And when they were asked, they said, like Peter repeatedly, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Until finally they said, yes, Lord, with your help. Yes, with the help of God. That is what we celebrate. And from that time on, 25 years ago, there has been a blending of voices. Because the voice of these three men were borrowed by the Lord so that the Lord may be heard by God's people. So the voice of Mario, Allen, and Alvin became the voice of Jesus for God's people. People needing consolation, people needing clarity, people needing guidance, people needing to be assured of blessings, people needing to be assured that God is among His people. The Good Shepherd used the voices of these men. in order to bless His people. But there have been times, my dear brothers and sisters, when they themselves will admit, and I myself will admit, that we dared to speak separate from that voice. And then, like Paul, we experienced that our voices did not land well. Our voices did not touch hearts. Our voices did not set hearts on fire, because they were only voices of men and no longer the voice of God. So we bring to this Jubilee Mass not only a thanksgiving for the voice that was heard, for the voice that was answered, for the human voice that responded. We also bring before this Mass those times when our voices, when our human voices were disconsonant with the voice of the Good Shepherd. And we, who were supposed to be shepherds of God's people, brought confusion, brought doubt, brought pain, and even death to God's flock. A jubilee is not just a moment of thanksgiving for that voice that was heard. It is also a moment of repentance for the voices that were disconsonant with the voice of God. But this jubilee is not just a voice of God and a voice of His priests. This jubilee is also about your voices. Your voices have been heard by these three. When they were discouraged, God used your voice to encourage them. When they were needing enlightenment, when they were confused, when they were feeling down, God used your voice in order to uplift them. Maybe it was not the voice of your advice. Maybe that same voice was like the voice of God. It did not come from your throat. It came from the voice of your smile. It came from the voice of your presence. It came from the voice of your tap on the shoulder. It came from the voice of eating supper, dinner, lunch with them, quietly, just assuring them. Just assuring them that God loves them. A jubilee is not just a moment of thanksgiving. A jubilee is also a moment of contrition. But it is also a moment to remember when we were downtrodden, when we were crushed, when we were threatened, when we were ignored, when we were taken for granted, when we were gossiped, when we were calumniated, when we were unjustly suspected, and yet we stood up, no longer with our legs, but with the wounded feet of the Lord. We stood up, no longer with ourselves, but with Christ, who has taken His place in our hearts. Father Mario, Father Allen, Father Alvin, thank you for your voice. And it is not just your baritone or tenor or bass voice. It is not just the voice that can be cultured in the conservatory. We thank you for the voice of your example, the voice of your witnessing, the voice of your silent tears, known only to God. The voice of your sacrifices, the voice of your life. Thank you for answering that voice. And thank you for lending your voice so that the Good Shepherd can reach His people. And when that time comes, my dear brother priests, my dear jubilarians, when you could not talk anymore, when you will be voiceless, when you would not be able to raise your hands to bless us. We know that the memory of your life will be an eternal voice for God's people. And when you die, we will still declare, you are a priest forever, and then celebrate the eternal jubilee in the house of the Father. Father Allen, Father Mario, Father Alvin, may the same voice you heard, come follow me, that mysterious soul-to-soul, heart-to-heart, mind-to-mind voice, may that same voice that you heard many years ago be the same voice you will hear, come, good and faithful voice of the shepherd, enter your everlasting reward. Amen.